think is very, very important, and also especially about 30, 40 years ago, and especially in Kulu Seminary, we raised the issues of gift and fruit and gifts of the Holy Spirit. So that created a lot of confusions among Christians, or even leaders. So that is very unfortunately that a lot of people use this gift of the Holy Spirit in the wrong ways. So that created a lot of problems within the church and within the church members. So this morning we have almost like 35, 38 minutes. I'd like to talk to you a little bit. You know, you might have heard a lot of that, but I just want to simplify for you to understand what the gift and what's the fruit of the Spirit thing, and what's the difference, and how about ourselves? How are we going to take these two, and then how are we going to develop them, and then how are we going to live it out according to our Christian faith and our Christian way of life? So actually, there's especially in the New Testament, there's so many places that emphasize about the gift, but they're very clear. They have for several places, but I'm going to talk about the fruit of the Holy Spirit first, okay? Because to me, I think that's supposed to be the first thing we should consider. Don't try to think of the gifts first, because gifts usually misleading us into our Christian behavior and our Christian ministry. So the very clear scripture in Galatians chapter 5 verse 22 said that the fruit of the Holy Spirit, love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. So this is 9 kind of fruit. Actually, to me, I think we did not emphasize this too much, because we take it for granted, say that if we become a Christian, automatically all these qualities, all these fruits will be with us. That understanding is correct, but the misunderstanding is you thought that you have it and naturally it will grow, or it will become more mature in your Christian life or your spiritual life. It's not true. Why I said that you have that potential, that the fruit of the Holy Spirit is within each one of us. You know why? Because when God created us and follow His image according to His quality. So all these 9 qualities that we mentioned, love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control, all in God. And then God created us in His own image. All these qualities are already within us. We have it. But the problem is, we do not bring it out and develop it. You know, when Paul wrote a letter to Timothy, he said, you know, be careful. You know, the gift that have the elder already lay hand on you, and develop it and use it. Same thing happened to the fruit of the Holy Spirit. God have given to us. That is our responsibility to develop that fruit, let the fruit grow. But the Holy Spirit have given to us. And then the Holy Spirit will help us. So in other words, when I was teaching in seminary, they asked me to teach a course that that I like it a lot, and spiritual formation. So how you develop your spiritual life. So I use this almost like first quarter or something, use these 9 qualities one by one to help each student. students to understand that how they can invoke this so-called fruit of the Holy Spirit to increase their quality, their effectiveness, and also the influence of our fruit of the Spirit. To me, I think the fruit of the Spirit is our being. See, I always teaching the student in seminary say that we have to be able to separate between being and doing. So especially for the Thai people, we cannot separate these two. Being and doing is the same. Whatever you do, I don't like it. I don't like you. So you make a conclusion. Said doing and being is one. So that's why last time I mentioned that Nancy's mom, when the kid, you know, the kid did something wrong, he said, "Nancy, I don't like your doing, but I always love you." So the mother know how to differentiate being the child, being a person, being someone that has feeling, someone that wants love and desire people's care. So that being, Nancy's mother knows. But Nancy's mother also know how to separate something she said, something that she did, no good. So we too. So when we, you know, experience with someone did something wrong to us, don't cut them off. Say, "From now on, I'm not going to be your friend." That means you reject his being. His whole being, you reject it. So you have to be able to accept his being and reject his doing. Teach them how to behave better. Okay, so I just want to let you know the fruit of the Spirit is our being. Something that needs the process of developing. Slowly developing into the fullness of that fruit. Have you seen the fruit? You know, I always use the mango, you know, in Thailand, because the mango, when it's little by little they grow, and then until they come to the point that they start to turn little bit spots of yellow, then they start to, you know, to spread the yellow color, the whole mango, then it's ripe. So the same thing, the fruit of the Spirit in our body, in our life, the same thing, you got to start somewhere. When you start it, when you become a Christian and you accept the Holy Spirit gives you all those gifts, you know, then you have to develop it. And you have to join with the Holy Spirit. I like that, you know, Galatians. After this, you know, verse 22, chapter 5, 25 said, "Since we are born of the Spirit, therefore live by the Spirit." So the Spirit will guide us. The Spirit will enhance us to grow, to develop our spiritual fruit. So it's not ourselves that we can do it, but you have to. You team up with the Holy Spirit that slowly, you know, to develop our spiritual fruit. Okay, that so spiritual fruit is our internal life. So we have to be more careful. We're gonna go to gift. Gift is outer, the external action. Okay, but the fruit is internal. No one see it. I can't see it, you know. Don't die, you have love or not, I don't know. But I see your action. When you see your action, that is your gift. If you have love, you know, then you can exercise your gift of serving, gift of taking care of people, you know. So, but you have to have that internal quality before you use that, you know, quality to show your inner life. That is very important. So I said that fruit is more important than gift. You have to have fruit to exercise. If you don't, see a lot of people, they have a gift. They do a lot of teaching, preaching, do a lot of things, but sooner or later they get tired. They feel like, ah, because they do it from outside in. But the real thing is we have to do it from inside out. You know, whatever you are in there, then you can easily to show your inner life to the outside world. So that is very important. So that we have to understand that. So the fruit of the Holy Spirit is the potential within each one of us. I mentioned a few minutes ago that God have created us. Every one of us have that fruit in there, you know. So in other words, when every kind of tree, they have potential to bear fruit, right? But sometimes, you know, some area in California, you bring mango from Thailand. Some people could raise mango here, you know, plant the mango, but it wouldn't bear fruit. But some they do. So that led us not to discuss about the scientific stuff, okay? But just general principle, every trees of any kind of fruit, there is potential to bear fruit. So our life, the same thing. Each one of us have that potential to have love, to have patience, to have joy, to have peace, to have kindness, to have goodness, to have faithfulness, to have gentleness, to have self-control. All this that within us. So our part, we just have to let it grow. Slowly let it grow and exercise and doing a lot of, take good care of your whatever potential you have within you, all right? Need to be developed through process. You know, a lot of people, the funny thing that, you know, people know that they lack of love, they say, God, give me love. Increase my love. Say, God did. How he did it? He brings some kind of, you know what, crazy people and always challenge you, always, you know, tell all the bad things about you. God bring those people to you. So what he want you to do? Develop what? Love. Because you say, I don't like this person. He just annoying me. He just bothering me. So God bring those people. Okay? And then depends on what you're going to ask for God. You said, oh God, I don't have self-control. I want to have the fruit of self-control. God will bring you to different situation. Give you the opportunity to exercise your self-control. You know, give you the situation that you cannot handle. Why? He gives you that opportunity to practice and to learn how you're going to control yourself. Your desire, your thoughts, your mouth, your lips want to say something bad, but you control. You want to be lazy, you don't want to go to school, and you tell you know, people say, oh, I'm sick. You know, you have to control your laziness. Should I not go in, or should I go in? So God gives you all kind of a situation to let you have that opportunity, time to practice, so that your fruit of that self-control could grow. See that? So when you pray, when you ask God something, you have to know what you're talking about, you're praying about. Otherwise, you blame God about it. So a lot of Christians do that. They ask one thing, but they expect God to be something that God usually not doing what they expect God to do. You know? So the fruit should be the foundation of, you know, exercising the gifts. Have to be the foundation, have to be the first. I always like to use the wagon, the horse and the cart. So the fruit had to become first. A lot of people so eager to use the gifts, but they forget how to handle the fruit, how to develop, how to increase the capacity of their being, you know. And then sooner or later, when they do a lot of serving and exercising their gifts, they get tired, and then they get discouraged, you, because you don't have that being to back you up. So you can't give up. First thing, you have to think of the fruit of the Holy Spirit first, okay, before you do a lot of serving. Okay, now let's go to the gifts of the Holy Spirit. As I mentioned to you, there are many Bible verses, the scripture that concentrate to emphasize the gifts. There are several places. And different schools, different people emphasize how many kinds of gifts. But through the study, through many denomination, to survey, the Bible mentioned how many kind of gifts, but there's so many disagreement about how many kinds. But from the standard is more than 29 kinds of gifts. You know, there are Romans 12, 6 to 8, okay? Then there are 1 Corinthians 12, 8 to 10. Then 1 Corinthians 20, chapter 11, 12, verse 29. Ephesians chapter 4, 11. And 1 Peter chapter 4, 11. You count it, is some people count it 34, some people count it 39, some people count it 31. It is not that important, but all we know is more than 29. So I put it 29 plus gifts of the Holy Spirit. So if you're really interested, there's so many books written about spiritual gifts and the fruit of the Holy Spirit, okay? And even you go into the internet, they'll give you all kind of information about this. And then different school, different denomination, they emphasize differently. So you have to find which school or which denomination you want to do the research. But for the scholar like yourself, I'd like to encourage you to study all kinds, so that you've got all kinds of thinking, so, you know, perspectives, and also you can see different kind of gifts in the different perspectives. You know, don't just look at one teacher, one book or anything, but more you can study, you can see all more about the gifts and the fruit of the Holy Spirit, okay? And I summarized several thoughts for you about the gifts. Said different kinds of gifts, one thing that you have to have, not your gift is not the best or the top one. No. Each one of us, God give us a different gifts. Okay? And different ways of serving. You want to serve, some people play plum, you know, drum, and some people guitar, some people violin. That's great. So that makes the sound so, what do you call it? So rich. And that sounds very rich and very natural. It sounds in the natural. So different way of serving. And Paul was talking, if just the whole body, just hand? No. Whole body, just eyes? No. Different parts of the body parts, but one body. Same thing, that, you know, God gives us different gifts, but serving one church, and then being given by one Holy Spirit. So that we have to understand that different ways of working, okay, not one way of working. So that's why when you are more mature, when you become more secure within yourself, okay, have you worked with some people that are very insecure within themselves? I have worked with several leaders and so-called boss. They're very insecure. They always want to control everything. And everything wants to be come through me. We call it, you know, what do you call it? Bottleneck. everyone had to go through the bottleneck hill, you know, but the secure person within himself, they will let everyone have their freedom to think, to interact, and to suggest a good idea, good way of doing things. So that is the secure person, and can work differently. Not one way, but there's different way, a different kind of works. That is for the good of all, you know. The gift not given for you personally, but for the whole church. So that is the very crucial mistake for many Christians. So if they're good at one thing, they just, that's me, you know. I'm somebody because I'm good at, some people good in healing. So they just make the whole ministry for himself, you know, healing ministry. But they just look down upon all kind of ministry in the church. No, it's not. Because you cannot, the body cannot just emphasize one body, one part of the body. Or the church cannot emphasize one kind of ministry. You cannot. You have to emphasize in a balanced way. The body is balanced. Yeah, there's some part maybe is more important function, you know. If you lose one arm, you wouldn't be dead. Okay, but if you lose your heart, you're gone. Or use your lung, you know, both lungs. But lose one lung, you still can. Even some part of the lung, you still can live on. But if you lose your heart, your brain, gone. So the function-wise could be different. Important, not important. But the value, the importance of, you know, in the body part is the same. So God look at us the same, the value-wise, okay? But in terms of function, could be different. See, now let's look at it. Say, each one at least get one kind of gift. The Bible said that God give everyone at least one kind of gift. You cannot say that I have no gift. No. At least you have one kind. But some people, God given many gifts.